Hello and greetings from Iceland. This is a day when we check out the drone thermal camera like it should be done. And I would have liked to do this test right after I got the drone, but it's a 1,000 kilometer trip to the craters where I wanted to do my first test, and the weather has been a bit dull and the nature yellow. So I've been using the time to do some marketing work before the summer. But then I found out about this geothermal area undergoing some changes affecting Iceland's highway number 1, like I told you about in my last video, so I just had to take off, and now I'm back with some thermal footage to share. And not just from this geothermal area, but also from the craters. That will be my next video, and actually quite many places. But let's start with Iceland's hottest road. This is the north side and we can see the steam. So let's swap to thermal or infrared. And with that function, we can see this little fracture very clearly. It's quite a bit of steam coming up from it, and it is somewhere around 10-20 meters long. So let's dive down there for a moment. This was shot after I drove for almost 5 hours. So I was also going to use the chance to get myself something to eat, since I just love those natural kitchens we have all around. But in this case, the stone wasn't hot enough to fry it, so it was just a steam-cooked egg this time, with some very natural moss taste to it. And it's a very good meal for the road, but I have to warn you that the moss tends to get stuck between your teeth, so it's better to do the eggs where you can fry them. And let's move up again, and you have to know that this was my first proper thermal test. So of course I had some problems with the settings and such, and also how to display the thermal images, because I have 10 color palettes to choose from. So there is some work that awaits me, like finding the right sensitivity settings and color palettes for each subject. But the most important thing is of course the sensitivity, and notice those 3 dots there. Those are the drill holes that were made last week for thermometers, and I covered it in my last video. So the accuracy of the camera is excellent, picking up small holes like this. But when it comes to the videos, it is a precision work, since when the camera is constantly moving, the thermal readings can easily be distracted. And it is very likely that the TIFF still images that the camera can produce will be the best images that I will get, but in this case I was just going after the bigger picture, so this resolution was fine for me. And the biggest surprise from this tour was the range, the long range of the thermal camera. Like it could see the nearby power plant 3 kilometers away like a glowing Christmas tree, and it did actually pick up another part of the road that is warm. And that area didn't get any media attention last week, so it might be that they didn't notice it. So I sent an email to the road administration and showed this to them. And when we look at that part of the road, we can see the Hveradalir geothermal area in the background. Some of the energy from there is being harvested and pumped into a nearby geothermal power plant. And where this will be going, it's just impossible to say, so I can't add anything to my video or the Geology Hub video that has been made about this. It looks now that the worst case scenario might be that we have to move the road, but there are other roads we can use while that would be done, so that won't be a problem. But at least this gave me a chance to get this set of thermal images. And I think it might be even more interesting to go there again in a few weeks and do another set of video. See how the heat has changed, if it has. And I'm ending this today with shots from the geothermal area. It's a kind of abstractor, and it's plenty to come since I was all over the Reykjavík Peninsula with 2 drones. So I have plenty of material for several more videos, and they will be online very soon. So you will also see the Hveradalsfjall volcano revisited. And if you are new to my channel, you can check out the subscription button. And as usual, I'm leaving links to my print-on-demand stores. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.